Hey everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. Today is another LEGO Top 10 Mocks of the Week episode where I show you guys the coolest custom creations that I happen to see people building in LEGO throughout this last week. As always, there are a ton of extra links in the description below, not just the top 10, and I highly recommend that you click on those links and check out more of the cool custom builds that people are making all around the world. 10 is a nice round number, but at the end of the day, there are, I don't know, hundreds of cool things people are making all the time, every day, and this is just a very quick highlight reel. So anyways, before I jump into the very first build, the custom creation that went up in our web store this week is the Haunted House from Lucas Quick, and it is a wonderfully detailed, decrepit, and slightly creepy building. It's got tons of awesome details. I highly recommend you check out the video. There's a link to the web store in the description as well. And if you enjoy our content, you can always like, subscribe, comment, do what you want to do, share the video, anything. And now let's jump into the first build. From Jan T, we have the build Pacifica 2077, based on the upcoming game, Cyberpunk 2077. We have here what looks like a nice little slice of life from this dystopian futurescape that seems to be built in kind of a modular setup. I believe the base is 32 by 32, though this building is a little bit more narrow, and all the streets here, the half of the street that you can see, is completely brick built. From this angle, it's maybe not quite as easy, but you can see there's actually a slope that goes down one edge of the building, and ultimately, there's just a lot of fun details to notice here. Personally, I like the graffiti that's brick built into the side of the white wall. The sidewalk has lots of fun little cracks. The bright blue teal building certainly pops against the rundown backdrop. Each of the characters looks very distinctive, and the palm tree is just a nice touch. It's the first time I've shown off anything from Jan T. Excellent model. Then from Malt Dorosky, we have the 2019 Porsche 99X Electric. From the name, you can guess correctly that this is an all-electric car, and it's part of the Formula E series, not the Formula One. Even though it's got a lot of looks that feel kind of similar to a Formula One series, this indeed is not part of the same circuit. At the end of the day, it's driving at speeds that are so incredibly fast that a lot of the looks kind of have to be the same, so the car itself doesn't fly off the ground when it reaches its max speeds. And personally, I just love the use of those slope bricks that are built on their sides to allow for such a smooth look front and back. The builder also has a wonderful picture showing off each of the sub-assemblies, and while each individual piece here doesn't look insanely complex, the fact that they all fit together like a glove is no small feat. It also scales incredibly well with his other Porsche, and now we're showing off an excellent build here from Timothy Kachev titled Here's Johnny. We've been following this guy for a very long time. He's an excellent designer. In fact, he does have his Orca build up in the web store, and this is, of course, a recreation of the very famous shot in The Shining when Jack Nicholson is banging through the bathroom door with an axe. Only this time, it's a brick separator. The details for the busted door is great, but really, it's the expression on the face that we get here for Jack Nicholson. My favorite build details probably include the pieces made for the teeth, the arch bricks in tan that kind of outline the shape of his mouth, and I also like the use of those kind of Technic pointy pieces to make up the slicked hair. If you want to see some wonderfully creative designs, I highly recommend you check out his Flickr in the description below. And then not too long ago, there was a, I think it's an ideas contest that asks people to make up the new futuristic Harley Davidson motorbike. There have been tons of great entries. There's a few flashing by the screen now, but my favorite one comes from Bob DeQuatre. It's the Harley Davidson E Wanderer, partially because the motorbike here feels like an old school Harley where it doesn't look quite as big and beefy, but still retains a wonderfully classic shape. What truly makes it unique though is the hollow or almost non-existent insides of the tires. It's really just like a wide rim with no rim. And I love the use of those balloon pieces that make up what I originally is a gas tank area, but it seems to be the front cover of the electric motor. There's a lot of great uses of slope and arch pieces, and that one brick built figure shin leg piece for the seat fits in just right. There's also a link to the building contest if you want to see all of the individual entries. And then this next build comes from Brick and Nick. This guy never stops creating, and his build style isn't what I would call simplistic, but very, very accessible. This is the microscale Koholint Island from Link's Awakening, and it's just a little diorama or model that it looks to me like it's just perfectly complete. I think he's managed to fit all the colors of the rainbow on here and has a distinct build style included to fill out every type of tree, and there's also some wonderful creativity making up the smoky ring or the cloudy ring around the volcano. At the end of the day, this is a model that both has the feeling of expert behind it, but also looks like an average person may be able to tackle something similar on their own. You should definitely check out his other microscale video game maps. I personally love the Mario Kart one a lot too. And now we are visiting Moco. The designer Moco made a wonderful little grasshopper mech called Hopper. I've seen many designers do things like this in the past, where they combined the organic or biological animal or plants with the mechanical, and there's some wonderful little highlights that Moco included here that I think cannot be understated. Those metal bars, I believe, come from train wheels. They make up the antenna, and you can see, I think, one or two in the back for the back legs. That spring piece used in the back is also just a wonderful detail. I doubt this model obviously jumps, but you do know, everybody knows that those are the big, powerful legs that allows a grasshopper to really jump, so it makes sense that you'd have a bigger, stronger, heavy-duty piece of machinery to illustrate that power. With the minifigure sitting in the seat there, I would be very curious to know what the G-forces or Newton meters behind the power of a machine like this would be. Something tells me it would be pretty darn painful to be sitting in that seat once this thing actually takes off. I believe Chris Perron was in last week's top 10 mocks as well, but this is the Ridge Ranger, and I could not ignore this model. In terms of color composition, this is just such a wonderful looking piece. The model itself is teal with a lot of gray and a little bit of yellow slash gold highlighting, while the clearly alien surface has a wonderful way of bubbling into some vibrant color pink. Aside from the wonderful color palette, we have some amazing and very complex looking design for the wheels. That's all minifigure arms that are clipped onto some 1x1 modified clip pieces, and underneath you can see some very subtle gold rim sort of rubber detailing as well. Also, the internals of this Ridge Ranger feel very, very robust and super mechanical underneath everything, and only the very top of this rider has a somewhat simple and stylized bit of detailing. You might not have seen it, but this is my favorite use so far of a brick separator because it's only the underside, so those ridge lines just kind of fit in a little bit better with the rest of the smooth bricks. Now we're getting into the last three. Tim Goddard has made a Millennium Falcon in exact 1:72 scale. My bet is that this isn't too far off from maybe the size of a Millennium Falcon play scale set, at least in terms of length and relative width. So when you see this ship built out at this size, I love to see that the cockpit is so much smaller, because that's actually how this ship normally looks when you see a model from the original. Like every Falcon, we have tons of wonderful little color details and little mechanical bits sticking out from which way and another. And personally, I think this is one of the best Falcons built at this particular size. He's got a few other Star Wars ships that are built at this, what I would call, MIDI scale as well. And I don't know for sure, but I have a feeling they would probably fit in pretty well if he lined them all up together. When it comes to number two in the lineup, we've got a massive diorama built by just two builders coming from Brick Rebel and Monstrophonic. This is the LEGO Steam Company. The steampunk aesthetic has been part of the building community for quite some time, not just within the LEGO community. And I have to say, this is probably one of the best fully realized steampunk areas or models that I've ever seen. It's hard to focus on any one individual piece here. The flying blimps are excellent. We've got a model at the bottom that looks strikingly similar, or at least inspired, by Jabba's sail barge, which I like a lot. The exterior gold-rimmed elevator on this one building really captures a lot of my imagination, and each and every building has just a wonderful amount of ornate details. The arched bridge that goes over the gold-rimmed train tracks has a wonderful outline of that relatively new roller coaster track piece, and the rising steam from all the different chimneys makes this whole place really feel alive. I've only just barely scratched the surface of this model. I highly recommend you take a closer look at a lot of the pictures. And now for the last build of the week from Zato Vince. This is the Joker bust. I believe the bust is based on the animated Batman TV series Joker. And I have to say, at this size, there are few, if hardly any, other LEGO creations that look quite quite as animated, quite as seamless, or quite as creepy and lifelike. Magically, it seems all of the shapes and slopes match up with each other, like the pieces were designed to be put together like this or something. And if I had to choose a favorite bit of design detailing, which I surely can't, but I love the black rim outlines for the eyes, the red horn pieces outline the lips quite well, and the purple suit has an ever so slight slope leaning back, which does wonders to add to sort of the three-dimensional suggestion of the rest of the body. The teeth look great, the hair is slicked back in a way where you feel like you can kind of see those individual strands, and this is a custom creation that I feel like would be impossible to improve on. Now those were my top 10 mocks of the week. Hope you guys enjoyed. Remember, there's tons of links in the description below if you want to see more. Thanks so much for watching, everybody, and if you enjoy our content, you can always like or subscribe, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault.